All right, so in this video, we're going to take a look at the Cypress plugin ecosystem, as well as take a look at the Cypress.json file, which will allow us to do a little bit more customization, but specifically, it'll help us with setting things like environment variables, which will help with some reusability and customization. So the goals for this video are to use your first Cypress plugin. We're going to be using a plugin called Cypress Testing Library. And by doing that, we'll help you understand the benefits of leveraging React Testing Library's commands. So what Cypress Testing Library does is it allows us to use the commands like find all and find by that React Testing Library offers. And so it'll help to kind of like augment the get and find commands that we learned about in the previous video. And then additionally, we'll utilize the Cypress JSON file to create environment variables specifically here, but it'll be kind of our first taste, our first look at that customization that we can do through the Cypress.json file. Okay, so you can see here in my terminal that we're running a local version of this. So we're not using the live version. We're using localhost 8080. And so if you look in package JSON, there's a couple of different start scripts. I'm on Windows, so I use the start CI Windows. If you're on Mac, start should work just fine for you. And then here's our test file. Remember, it's in our Cypress folder inside of the examples directory. And so now that we're caught up kind of where we're at, here it is, localhost 8080 running, and this is the same application that you saw live, but we've just got a local version of it running. And then here on Cypress's documentation section of their website, they've got this plugins directory. And inside, they've got all sorts of different plugins for doing different things that Cypress might not offer out of the box. And so what we're going to be looking at specifically here, and you can see there's a ton of them, is Cypress Testing Library. And so this will allow us to add on to the like get and find commands that we saw in the previous video. And so if we click into this and take a look at the documentation here, we can see the Cypress Testing Library GitHub page. And it's got all the documentation that we need to get us up and running. But basically the cool thing is that you're able to now use all of the React Testing Library's find by and find all by commands. And so if we click on this and go to this link, we'll be able to see in this API, we can do like by test ID, for example. So get by test ID. So we would be able to do find by test ID here, find all by test ID, find by title, find all by title. By placeholder text, I think that's a cool one. So find by placeholder text, find all. So notice that each of these has a find by and a find all by. So similar to how, well, I guess a difference to point out would be that when we use the get command, that just defaulted to finding any elements that matched on the page. When you're expecting a single element to, like, for example, have a specific placeholder text, then you can do find by and it'll find that one. However, something to look out for is that if you have multiple, this will throw an error, and then that's when you would use find all by. So just some quick examples, but we'll dive into actually using this here in just a second. So let's take a look at the documentation and the installation section. So we're going to grab this npm script and then flip over to our terminal. I'm gonna go ahead and control C out of this and clear it. And then I'm gonna paste that in. Okay, so now that that is done, I'm gonna run clear again. Package.json, just gonna check to make sure that it's in here in our dev dependencies. And we can see testing library Cypress, so that's good. And then there's a couple of other things. So inside of our Cypress support commands JS file, we need to add this line. So let's copy it. And then let's go to support commands. So in Cypress support commands.js, we can now import that that list of commands for us, and now we'll be able to use it. So let's just double check. So we imported it, and now we can chain off of that base CY command by doing CY dot, and then any of those find by or find all by commands that Cypress testing library, the plugin offers to us via React testing library. So let's go ahead and take a look at our Kitchen Sink app. So we have our homepage. And let's make sure that it's running again. So I'm just going to up arrow a couple times to the npm run script. And now it's running again. I'm going to clean some stuff up here. So I'm going to close out package JSON. And commands, we don't need to open anymore either. And so now we're in this index.html file. So notice that all of this is just written in HTML. And so we've got our body here, and this is the home page that we were looking for before. So now what we can do is we can find specific elements, say by text. So there's a piece of text here called cypress.io. So let's go ahead and write a simple test to just make sure that that exists. So let's copy this. I'm just highlighting it and copying. And then in my first test.spec.js, we can actually go ahead, since we've seen all these, we don't need to run through them a bunch of times. We can comment this out. And now beneath this, we can say it correctly renders the Cypress website link. And then similarly, we can have our callback function. And then we can say cy.findByText. And then we can have our string, cypress.io.shouldExist. So I'm going to go ahead and open up a new terminal here. And let's go ahead and run that script. So it'll be npm run cy colon open. Okay, so now that that's open for us, we can go ahead and click on that test. Okay, so this test passed, but there is one thing that I caught that I'm wondering if you did as well. The URL is that live URL. So one thing that we forgot to do was update this this URL here. So that's one use case for why we're going to be looking into the Cypress JSON file to help us not have to remember this piece. But we can see now find by text cypress.io, and that does exist. And if you click on this, you can see printed output to your console. If we inspect this and open up our console, we can see that the find by text command was what was entered. You can see there was one input, specifically something that satisfied the argument that was passed into find by text, and good information here for sure. So one thing that we can do now that we have this set up is we can set a base URL so that we don't have to remember which URL we need to visit each time. So you'll remember in our test at the top, we have cy.visit this base URL. And so what we can do now instead is we can open up our Cypress JSON. So I've got mine open already, but just showing you where it is in the root directory, cypress.json. And now what we can do is inside of this object, we can pass in some arguments. And so the first, what we want to do is set our base URL. So our base URL is going to be where, as the name implies, where all of our tests kind of start off running. So what we can do is we can set it to that localhost 8080. So let's go ahead and do HTTP :// local host 8080. and hit save. And so now in the myfirsttest.spec.js, what we can do is we can do cy.visit and then just a slash. And it looks like I accidentally deleted the first apostrophe, but let's do a slash here. And now I hit save, and now let's open up that Cypress menu again, or the Cypress runner. And now if I click on that, you can see localhost 8080 is now automatically navigated to just by visiting this slash. So we can add on to this, which is going to be kind of nice. So let's say that we want to go to like the commands page. What we can do next is we can update our test. So we could do like before each, we could do cypress.visit/commands. And so now what this will do is it's going to visit localhost 8080/commands. Now here, the issue obviously is that this commands page doesn't have what we're looking for, but you can see now how you can append the different strings to the end of your base URL. And then you don't even have to think about adding localhost 8080 or your live URL. You just have it in your Cypress JSON file. Okay, so let's go ahead now. Let's say that we have some things that are like reusable. So maybe it's like you're logging into your application and you have a username and password for like the test user that you're gonna have. Or maybe you have like, maybe you're running your front end and then you have a like a back end server that's running like on a separate port, and you want to have that URL accessible. You can set all of these things as environment variables and then access them through a Cypress environment variable syntax. So let's take a look at how we would do that. So inside cypress.json, we have our base URL. After that, we can do env, and now anything inside of here, we can list a key, which is how we'll access it, and then a value, which is going to be the value that's returned from that. So let's say, like, we'll say, navbar text. And in this case, we just want to grab it from this cypress.io text that we entered before. We'll come back to how we'll update this in a minute. But for now, in our Cypress JSON file, let's go ahead and add cypress.io. And then that way, if we reference navbar text elsewhere, like let's say, for example, that we want to at each of our pages that has a navbar, we want to make sure that it's rendering correctly. And so what you could do is you could paste that in that find by text cypress.io just to make sure that the navbar is appearing correctly and is rendering the correct text on each page. But then say you change it from cypress.io to cypress.dev. Now you have to go through every single test or every single test file and re-update that. With this method, and I know it might seem kind of trivial, but this is an example of how you can leverage environment variables to then only have to change it in one spot rather than going through each one. So what we can do here is we can make sure that this is saved. And then in the test file, we can create a variable. So we can do this. Inside. Let's do it above the context. And notice up here too, I have this at TypeScript no check. So VS Code was giving me some issues, so I just added a no check to disable the linter in this file. So if you're getting some odd red squigglies, then you can go ahead and implement that, and it'll hopefully solve it for you as well. So up here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to say const navbar text, and I'll do cypress.env. And then I want to take a look at the Cypress JSON file. So navbar text is what we called it here. So what we'll do in here is we'll do env, and then inside of quotes, we'll do navbar text so that it matches the Cypress JSON key here. And so now we have access to navbar text in this variable, which we can copy, and then find by text we can paste in this variable. And so now we're setting our variable here. We're then grabbing it with this cypress.env and then referencing it by the key. And now we have it stored in this constant, and then we're passing it into navbar text here. So let's save it. Let's flip back over to our Cypress test runner. Now we've got the test running again, and it's passing again. So you can see find by text cypress.io. So it passed in the value as expected. But this way, again, now if we're on the home page, but say we wanted to make sure that Cypress.io rendered on the commands page and the utilities page and the Cypress API page, by setting it in the Cypress JSON as an environment variable, now we have that reusable piece of information that we only have to change once if we end up changing this piece of our nav bar. So as a quick recap, in this video, we went over how to navigate the extensive directory of Cypress plugins and how to install our first one with the Cypress Testing Library plugin. We also saw how to leverage the Cypress JSON file to set our base URL so that we don't have to remember to type out the entire thing every time, as well as setting some environment variables so that we have access to certain reusable values that we plan on using over and over again. So in the next video, what we're going to do is take a look at sort of the foundational aspects of Cypress in terms of how it's built on JavaScript. So Cypress is built in a particular way where things are kind of queued up and work in asynchronous nature. And so that can throw some little hiccups in things when you're writing tests. And so we're going to take a look at the asynchronous nature of Cypress and some gotchas to look out for along the way. Of course, as always, if you're looking to learn more, you can always check out our blog at lambdatest.com/blog, as well as our community page at community.lambdatest.com for cool ways, tips, and tricks to get certified and learn more about Cypress and LambdaTest. So as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.